Hey everyone, really excited to showcase to you our latest addition to the Vizlib product offering, hot off the shelf Vizlib Collaboration. So what's prompted us to develop this new extension and product has always been customer feedback. People have the need to add annotations, to comment, to have discussions directly where the data is. If you look at classic dashboarding, such as this example here you see on the screen, it has always been a case of logging in by yourself, making selections, drilling down, finding answers to your questions, finding insights. But then there's a disconnect in our view, a disconnect with how you then prompt actions or you then use those insights and put them to work. So you typically take that out to email, pick up the phone for a call, or you have a meeting. We felt there's something that we can do to improve that process. The second aspect is also very often that you're looking at an app or your data, and you're probably not by yourself. You're probably on the same dashboard with 10 other users or more. So why isn't there, if you have a question, some sort of knowledge transfer that can happen directly where the data is? This is why we decided collaboration is a great value add that can enrich that experience. So this is what we've developed. Effectively, with Vizlib Collaboration, you will have an extension that will prompt on the right hand of the screen. So it will not disrupt the standard dashboarding flow, and very subtly prompt the screen here that you can expand, and you see here that a lot of comments, a lot of conversations have happened here. Not only conversations and comments, but also the context is preserved, right? If you look at some of these comments that have been posted by myself, you see there's a tiny bookmark icon here that if you click on this, it can reapply the selections that I was looking back then when I made that comment. So you're preserving the context as a matter of fact. It's very easy to add a comment, just like any other chatting technology. You can just write stuff in, almost like Slack, Teams, or like an email. You can add emojis. So it's actually very, very, very interactive. But, you know, again, the good thing is that it preserves selection in that particular case. Either this way, or this is the way to comment on a sheet, but we also enabled you to have a commentary or a discussion directly on a chart level. So if you take, for example, here, let's say sales versus goal, I can click on this and I can see commentary or annotation that have been directly related to that particular visualization. So you can say, you know, select Southern here and say minus 20% doesn't look right. Anybody can help, right? At which point this will be shared with the rest of the users on the dashboard that will be more than happy to dive into your comment, apply the same selection, and then, you know, prompt a discussion here. So really, really functional, really, really powerful for that particular case. And if you don't want to make a comment, you can also make a private note for myself, review later, right? That only me myself see, and I can use it part of a reminder. Now, of course, you can play around with this. You can have it as collapsed. You can also either have it, you know, as an expanded mode, right? So, you know, again, this is Vizlib, so you have a lot of customization options. You can even remove the sheet level commentary and have it only on visualization if that's the most preferred way. So we have lots of ways how you can, there's lots of ways how you can deploy this and ultimately, you know, use it in the way that your users want it. Well, one particular use case is also the fact that you can use it as part of a workflow. So for example, here we're looking at 2013. I can drill down that number. I see June is a little bit off. I can make some selections here and select international, let's say. And let's say I'm curious about this, about October. I don't understand why daily sales have dropped significantly. And the particular user is not there on the dashboard. I need the answer to that question fast. So what you can do here is you can actually send a notification to that particular user. You can go in here and instead of writing a comment in the chat here, you can expand this and share a comment via email. So in this case, I'm gonna send myself an email and say, hey Martin, October 13 numbers look very low. Is this the case, right? And not only I can put in here a comment, but in order to, because the comment itself will be difficult to answer via email, I can also attach the data and I can also attach the image here, right? So I can then click on this and that will be post it, of course, as a comment on the here on the dashboard, which you can see here has been shared with Martin. And then within the email arrives, you will see here that the recipient will have received a notification that a new comment has been posted. Hey Martin, October numbers looks very low. Why is this the case? And I also include an image here, and not only an image, but also the underlying number if you want to do some further analysis directly. So it's an extract. If you were then the recipient of that email, you can actually click here. And what it does is it opens the dashboard where the comment was made. It not only opens the dashboard, it opens the sheet, and it also applies the selections, the bookmark of that particular comment. So fully interactive both ways, and a great way to enhance the user experience, the ability to discuss and argue with data directly on your dashboard.